So we have our next speaker, Dr. Bhupesh Bagga. He is a consultant in cornea cataract services and children's eye care hospital in Lalu Prasad Eye Institute at Hyderabad. He did his fellowship from the same institute. In addition to his clinical work, he is a researcher, and his research work is focused on corneal ulcer treatment. He's also involved in managing pediatric corneal disorders and complex ocular surface diseases. He's an investigator of grants related to HSV keratitis and phytum keratitis funded by ICMR and DST. He has been actively involved in teaching residents and fellows. So over to you, Dr. Bhupesh Bagga.
Course. Hello, good evening everyone, and
Good evening.
Hope I was audible.
Yes, sir, we can hear you.
My slides are
just waiting, Bhupesh.
Nikhil has to know stop share screen first.
That.
Yes, Bhupesh, you're in.
Okay. So thanks again to AIO Scientific Committee and especially Dr. Somshila for the kind invitation and giving me the opportunity to present my case. So I'm going to present a case of Pythium keratitis. I was actually 41-year-old female presented in 2016 from Prayagraj, Uttar Pradesh, with a redness, painful decrease in vision, along with white discoloration of the left eye since past 1 month, with a vague history of giving something fall during cooking 1 month back. So she was actually diagnosed and managed as microbial keratitis as a Citrobacter grown in the culture, which she was carrying the medical report and which was sensitive to moxifloxacin, erythromycin and all, and resistant to ciprofloxacin and ofloxacin. So based upon that and other clinical features, the treating cornea specialist started on voriconazole 1 hourly and moxifloxacin 1 hourly, along with atropine and tablet astrozolomide. So this was the, I'm going directly to the cornea picture. This was the clinical picture of the cornea, which you can see with a dense infiltrate over this area. This area is almost thinning around 70%, which unfortunately slit is not on that. But important thing is there is a guttering around the infiltrate all around. This area is relatively clearer with fine tentacular-like lesions with extensions, with circumciliary congestion, and these are the points which I was trying to tell. So based upon that, we made diagnosis of microbial keratitis and differential based upon the history of 1 month with the Citrobacter grown in culture from elsewhere, but worsening on antibiotics, worsening on antifungals, the history of trauma while cooking something. So clinical pictures, which I just mentioned, like fine tentacles, are favoring either fungal or pythium, but she was worsening on antifungals. Peripheral guttering along with going for pythium as well as fungus both, but more towards pythium keratitis. Pinhead lesions are more for pythium as well as fungus both. So our differentials are in between the fungus or pythium, or it can be mixed infection as Citrobacter, which is a gram-negative bacteria grown from somewhere else. So if you just think about the pythium keratitis, this is a plaque-like lesion. The typical lesion presents like a plaque-like lesion, whitish lesion with granular and surrounding granularity. If you carefully look, you will see some fine tentacles and pinhead lesions around that plaque. Similarly, in other patient, like presenting like in hypopyon, but common things is the raised plaque and a guttering, along with fine tentacles and very fine tentacle and pinhead lesions. Clinically, both are looking similar, but few difference are there, which are like in pythium, you see fine tentacular lesions, which are very thick and very fluffy in cases of fungus. But in early cases of fungus, still can mimic Pythium keratitis. You won't see guttering like this in early stages of fungal keratitis, but you do see sort of guttering around the infiltrate and raised plaque in Pythium keratitis. So we scraped and we got filaments. I would just say filaments, but if you see the filaments are, if I am marking here, this filament is like this with only one clean septa I can see. Rest all are aseptate or sparsely septate, which is more clearer in KOH, which is like a aseptate band without seeing any septate. And the classical fold, like which you see here, which is very evident in KOH, which is not very clear in the grams. So if based upon that, we are actually seeing a broad branching aseptate, sparsely ribbon-like filament. On microbiologically, we can differentiate these two organisms, but yes, there are certain patients, they are actually not able to differentiate very clearly, but in majority-wise, we can see more septae and thinner filaments in terms of fungus, but sparsely septate or aseptate in terms of Pythium. Both organisms are different in structure of cell membrane also, and the important thing is that fungus has ergosterol, but Pythium doesn't have. So that actually gives that why this patient, if on Pythium, is not responding to voriconazole. Second thing is the growth on the chocolate agar is very, very faint, as in contrast to fungus, which is actually very clear. In Pythium, you see very submerged, thin growth with radiating edges, which when we transfer from chocolate agar to aqueous media with some garnish and leaves, we can actually generate spores from the sporangia. So this actually confirms the diagnosis of that we are dealing with the Pythium. So if you to make a diagnosis, we are having clinical signs of tentacles, pinhead lesions, guttering and plaque with worsening on antifungals, with smears showing aseptate, sparsely septate, ribbon-shaped filaments with culture and zoospore formation, actually towards Pythium keratitis. So now we have made a diagnosis of Pythium keratitis. So Pythium is basically a oomycete, which was actually initially diagnosed as a fungus. But later on, when we actually come to know that actually forming spores, and this is the technique of form spores, it actually come out to be a oomycete. So it was initially diagnosed as hyphomycosis destruens, which literally means that is a fungus which destroys literally everything. It is a human pathosis, basically a disease to start with tropical and subtropical countries as well as temperate. But we do see cases from other all over world. Now we have case reports from all over world of human pathosis. Human pathosis actually can be described in four categories, but most common is vascular, and second most common is ocular. The most important risk factor in terms of non-ocular is a thalassemia hemoglobinopathy, while in ocular pathosis is related to water. Rainy season is increased incidence, farming exposure, direct contact with water resource, and there are plenty of case reports with the use of contact lens use along with the Pythium. So it's not only acanthamoeba, which is very commonly associated with this. Pythium is also coming with second very important organism. Coming to management point of view, initially it was diagnosed as unidentified fungus, so it always been treated as with antifungals and then worsened. So this study actually, if you see the 30 out of 30, 14 patients got enucleation or eviscerations, but they came out to be conclusion that if you do early surgery, actually you can salvage the globe, but not visually outcome. This study from India actually says that from 46, 42 actually went surgery, but out of their 42 patients, 26 got very bad recurrence. So they also advise that early surgical intervention is the most important. So for this patient and for Pythium per se, the uncertainty exists, that uncertain response with medical treatment, outcome of surgical treatment is also very poor, and high chance of recurrence of infection, poor graft survival. So what to offer to our patient? Like if you see that, our patient was having late presentation, advanced keratitis, as well as central stromal thinning. So most of us think about that we should go for early keratoplasty, or now the early late is there, so we should go for keratoplasty. But some of us thinking that why should not try medical treatment? So based upon the drug susceptibility testing, which we performed in our lab, we come out to a protocol to treat Pythium insidiosum keratitis medically, and we managed to see some 14-15 patients, and we published in 2018 this paper in video. Based upon this initial experience, so we thought of trial of medical management with patient counseled about that and observe for thinning with explained prognosis that we patient definitely may or may not require therapeutic ketoplasty because of high recurrence rate. We try medical treatment. So we tried with combination of linezolid along with erythromycin ointment along with oral erythromycin tablet. So this was the patient at presentation. After 3 days, if you see that little thinning is more clear with little bit of consolidation of the endoexudate, which now appearing now, with a haze of 14 days, the difference is little bit obvious that this cornea, which was little bit of fuzzy, actually started clearing up. And to our excitation, this central cornea also was getting clearer. But the thinning progressed, so we applied tissue adhesive with very close follow-up that still the patient may need therapeutic ketoplasty early. But on follow-up, they started consolidating with vessels as Dr. Nikhil's patient of acanthamoeba patient is started same consolidating as a plaque, which I am just thinking that why both are behaving as exactly like a similar way. And then is after 105 days, it became like a central plaque, which I removed surgically and applied tissue adhesive, which after 150 days, it's completely healed. So we make a strategy that we should try antibiotic even in the large Pythium keratitis rather than going for treatment, surgical treatment. And if it worsen, then go for treatment. So we recently, this paper recently got accepted in ophthalmology, where we described that it can present as like in four format, whether like this 4A, 4B, 4C is the like our patient, 3A, 3BC is like without formation of plaque and just resolve like other microbial keratitis. But 2A, 2BC and 1 is actually a different way that one actually worsened on medical therapy and a large therapeutic graft was required in this patient. But second improved, but central perforated during the healing process and we need set of optical ketoplasty. So this way it responded. So, I'm done. So this is 1 year follow-up of this patient. And this is the follow-up recently, follow-up of 3.5 year, where I performed PK plus ECC, PCIOL for this patient with regaining of very good visual acuity. So with the strategic treatment, we can gain a very good outcome for even for very worst complication. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Bhupesh.